Hi everyone, so in this video you will learn how to use local storage API in JavaScript. It will basically give you the ability to store data right into your browser, and that will be in the format of strings. So we'll have a key and a value. For example, you want to store a user ID, so you can assign a key by the name of ID, and there will be a value which could be 1, 2, 3, whatever you want. Let's see it in action, how it actually works. As always, we need two files here. The first will be index.html. Another file will be script.js. So we need some code here. This is the code, basically a HTML structure which is required to have HTML page. Now we need a reference to a script file. We need two input elements here. Let's make use of div element. And input element, let's make the placeholder key. We'll give it a ID of storage key. I'll just copy and paste it here. We'll make it value, and let's make it storage value. Now we need a button, so let's make use of button element, make it submit. That's it. Now save it. Open this file in the browser. Let's see what kind of output we are getting. Pretty basic. So we're going to store the string which will be inside this input box as a key, and the string which will be inside this input box as a value. So let's get started. So we need a function here that will be setStorage. Okay. Now we need to make use of query selectors to get the values from these input boxes. So let's make it key. That will come from document.querySelector. We'll make use of ID, which in this case is storage key. And we want the value. Just copy this, paste it here, and it will be value. So let's make it storage value. Okay, it should be value, not value. Now we'll make use of local storage API, and there is a function by the name of set item. It will take key and a value. So let's use it here. Now save it, go to dev tools. In the application section, we have local storage. This is the local storage, just do it like this so that we can get a clear picture. As you can see, we can enter a key here. So let's make it ID, and we'll make a value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, whatever it is. And when you will submit, okay, nothing is happening because I forgot to use on click event here, so it will be set storage. So on click of this button, we'll submit it. So let's enter the values again. Okay, submit. Let's make it name Peter. Submit. So we are getting key and value. Yes. The best part of using local storage is that when you will reload this page, these values will still be there. Let's refresh this page. Okay, let me go to google.com. okay, so you can see for the google.com there's nothing, but when I will visit this page again, I'll get those values. So these values are bound to this domain. Now the question is how you can get these values. So let's go to console window. Okay, so as you know, we already have this key value pair here, name Peter. So we are going to get that value using that key, which is name. So we'll use a event here that will be load event. So we'll call this function and the window is completely loaded. So it will be console log. I'll do one thing, just make it value here. Use local storage dot get item. Okay, and we have to pass a key here. In this case, I'll make it name console log the value. So as you know, the value is Peter, so we'll get Peter in the console. You can see, let me refresh this for you again. See, if I'll put id here, I'll get the value of id. In case you want to get the key value, I mean the name of the key, you can make use of indexes here. So the very first inserted key will have the index of 0, then 1, then 2, then 3 and 4. In this case, we entered name first. Let me open this. Sorry for that. So you can see it will have index of 0 and this will have index of 1. So here, if I'll make key at the position of 0, I'll get name in return. You can see, if I'll make it 1, I'll get ID. If I'll make it 2, in that case, there's nothing at that position, will get null. You can see. Apart from setting and getting those values, you can also delete those values. Let me add a button here and make it remove storage. Let's make it remove. Okay. Now we need a function here. So just copy this and paste it here. Make it remove storage. Great. So I want to delete them by their key name. So just remove this part. Local storage, remove item. And it will take a key name. So we'll get it from the input box and we'll simply delete it. Now save it, go to browser, name and ID. So if I want to delete this ID thing, I can pass ID here, click on remove, it will be gone. If I'll put name here, remove, gone. One thing which you should know about local storage, in case if I'm adding a name Peter here, submit, I'm getting name Peter. If I'll make it marks later and submit it, it will basically override that value. So keys should be unique. If you'll supply the same key name with a different value, it will be overridden. Now instead of removing the item by the key name one by one, you can completely delete all the items with a click of a button. Let me show you this. Let's add a couple of items here. Let's make it name and 5, whatever it is. So we have 3 items here. If I want to remove all 3 with a click of a button, I can simply make use of clear function. Just delete this part. So make it local storage dot clear. Now save it here. Now I will click this remove button. They all will be gone. Now you have seen how to store strings in the local storage. But what in case you want to store an object in the storage? In such a scenario, we have to make use of json.stringify function, because in the storage you can only have strings, you can't have objects. Let me show you. So just delete this part, or just comment out instead of deleting it. We'll take only this part for the summation. Okay, so let's give it a key name of something ABC. Okay, and we'll store our object here. So let's make it name Peter, ID 123. So as you know, we'll have a key ABC and we'll have this object as a value. Here on load, we'll make it 0 because this will be the only value in the storage. Now save it, go to browser, click on submit, we got ABC and object. In the console, if I'll reload, I'll get the key ABC. Let's try to make use of get item function and make it ABC and see the output. Save it, you're getting object. If you want to get this kind of a data in return, you have to make use of stringify function. So let's separate this and create a variable. make it my object. So this is the object we have here, and here we'll make it of json.stringify my object. Great. Now let's store this. Okay, but first of all remove it, then store it. Now you can see we have the object here and it is in the format of JSON. Now when you want to retrieve it, you have to make use of JSON parse. Save it. Now just reload this. You can see we are getting our object back. One more thing which you must know, that in case you are making use of HTTP here and storing these values in the local storage, later you change your mind and you want to access these values via HTTPS protocol, so it will not work. Whatever the values which you have stored using the HTTP protocol, you can access it by HTTP only, not by the HTTPS. And it's vice versa. In case of HTTPS, whatever values you have stored, you cannot access them by the HTTP except HTTPS. So this protocol matters a lot. Now one last thing which I want to show you, if I close this browser, okay, and if I'll open it again, those values still be there. Let me open the console window. So this is our object. Local storage API and session storage API both have limitations on storing the data. You cannot store more than 10 MB of data. So if you are storing some data with the help of local storage API or session storage API, you better make use of try and catch block to catch the errors. I hope you got the point how it actually works. See you in the next video. Have a nice day.